This concert is an offering on part of the musicians. It is their most generous tribute to Patrick Leigh Fermor and the Cretan resistance and its fight for freedom and human dignity. That you have come all the way from Greece on your own initiative, and US, I also see as a support of our efforts with very limited funds and almost non-existent institutional framework to keep alive the exposure of and dialogue with Greek culture in Denmark. Many people far from Greece only see the country and its citizens as a bankrupt part of humanity that once hosted the most brilliant expressions of human civilization. But unfortunately, no, fortunately, from experience, I know that this image couldn't be more false. What must surprise any visitor to Greece who cares to dig a little bit under the surface and approach people living in Greece, listen to them, and not least listen to their expressions and creations in art, literature, music, theater, dance, architecture, as well as in humanistic scholarship, will realize that Greece is a country abundant in initiative and dedication to human dignity and a rich spiritual life. This is not to disregard the real sufferings and despair caused by almost a decade of austerity, but I underline that this is the chief raison d'être of the Greek Cultural Institute in Copenhagen, that Greek and Cypriot culture is worth listening to and developing dialogue and mutual learning processes with. The three musicians we shall listen to in a moment are bright examples of the excellence in performing art and being in sync with the medium and of simply accepting that as a human being with limited time on this planet, you can give some of your time to a higher purpose, something that is not profitable, that has no other meaning than the inexplicable joy that we humans can feel in the encounter of art, which gives no intellectual answers to the mysteries of life, but speaks to the heart. Instead of presenting the musicians and their merits, though I might say that all three have secondary professions too, I will give the floor to their music. So please join me in welcoming Venizelos Leventogiannis playing the Cretan laouto, right? Dimitris Rapakousios playing the Cretan boulgari. And Paddy League playing violin and perhaps boulgari.
Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ, Τρίνε.
Thanks very much. We're absolutely delighted to be here. I'll tell you very briefly. When Trina invited me to come, I said, of course I'll come and I'd love to play. Then I mentioned it to Dimitris, and my kubaros, the best man at my wedding, one of my best and oldest friends in this world. And he said, well, obviously I'm going to come. and then he said, well, why don't we ask Venizelos if he wants to come and play too? So we, from a solo act, this became a great reunion of old friends and fellow musicians who we normally see each other every other summer, so we got a jump start on that this year. So we're going to play music from Western Crete. I will, before each selection, I'll tell you a little bit of the background. I do want to call your attention, though, to these beautiful instruments. Trine said that all of us, aside from being musicians, perform musicians, have other careers. Dimitris's career is that he is, I think, the best and certainly the most sought after luthier, instrument maker, stringed instrument maker in Greece. So Dimitris made both the boulgari that he's playing and Venizelos' laouto, as well as many instruments that I play. He didn't make my violin, but he did repair it one day in Crete after he broke it. So it was my fault, but he's the one who dropped it. I should also say, I alluded at the beginning to all of these amazing coincidences and felicities, like the fact that Dimitris' great uncles are not only were one of them was an associate of Fermor's, but that songs composed by them are in this collection. Another of these coincidences is that this boulgari that Dimitris is playing, he made for the son of James Notopoulos, who is at the age of 70-something, is a budding musician. And so I'm going to be
taking this boulgari back to Boston to deliver it to Philip Notopoulos. After Dimitris rebuilds it, some aspects of it, because he's left-handed and Philip is not. So, amazing things. Anyway, we'll start. We're going to sing the complete version of the Ριζίτικο Hitler, να μην το καυχηθείς, πως πάτησε στην Κρήτη, ξαμάρτωτη την ίβρικες και λείπαν τα παιδιά της. Στα ξένα πολεμήσανε πάνω στην Αλβανία και πάλι πολεμήσανε. Hitler, don't boast that you took Crete. You found her unarmed. Her children were far away fighting in foreign lands in Albania, but still they fought. So, and then we'll follow it by two of the oldest dance tunes in the canon of Western Cretan music, in the Syrtos rhythm. The first one, the Protos Chaniotikos Syrtos, is rumored to have been composed, or the melody that was put together in the mid-18th century, when this form crystallized, was supposedly brought back by the last Cretan defenders of Constantinople, who the conquering Sultan Mehmet allowed to return home in reward for their bravery. And then we'll play a Syrtos from the village of Lusakies, which is the place where this type of dance was invented.
Hitler, να μην το καυχηθείς. Πώς πάει, πώς πάτησε στην Κρήτη. Πώς πάει, πώς πάτησε στην Κρήτη. Thank you.
μα παλικάριο θα βρεις το καλαθά. Όπου μάνα μου κοκαλά θα δώσεις.
Thank you very much. We'll now go on and play an old song that probably most likely dates to the Ottoman period in Crete. It's part of a larger genre of urban Ottoman music from Crete that we call tabakhaniotika. This is a song that was recorded and popularized by the great boulgari player from Rethymnos Stelios Fustalieris. It's called Ponemeni Kardia, a song of bitterly unrequited love.
Αφού είχες άλλον στην καρδιά, τι μ' ήθελες εμένα? Να με πληγώσεις, να πονώ, ώστε να ζω για σένα.
Since you already had somebody else in your heart, what did you want with me? Just to hurt me so that I would be in pain and I would live for you. A bit of light music here.
Hey, παίζεις με τσίφτο τις καρδιές για να γλεντάς τα νιάτα. Κι ύστερα τσις ξελείς μονά στου χωρισμού τη στράτα. Κι ύστερα τσις ξελείς μονά κάψουν την καρδιά σου. Τι πίκρες κι αναστεναγμοί θα κάψουν την καρδιά σου.
So now we'll play a rizitiko, but a more metered rizitiko song called Agrimia kia agrimatia mu. So the agrimi is the ibex, or the wild Cretan mountain goat. These very large goats with giant horns that roam wild in the mountains, particularly the White Mountains in southwestern Crete. And they're a symbol, they're a metaphor for the things you would expect: freedom and bravery and manliness. They're considered the hardest creature to hunt and the most ferocious. And so naturally, they've also become a symbol for the andartes, the resistance fighters. So this song is addressing the personified andartes, the agrimia, asking where their homes are, where they live, and the answer is up in the wild mountains. And even our parents are the wild places of the mountains. We're so dedicated to this life.
Αγρίμια κι αγριμάτια μου, αγρίμια κι αγριμάτια μου. Go!
γκρεμνά να εμάς οι τόποι μας. Γκρεμνάνε μας οι τόποι μας, γκρεμνάνε μας οι τόποι μας. Λες και να λες και στα χει, η μάδια μας τα χει. Τα σπήλια ράκια του βουνού, τα σπήλια ράκια του ξαναλέω του σεβδά, ούτε μια μανινάδα. Γιατί μου κάμε την καρδιά, γιατί μου κάμε την καρδιά. Γιατί μου κάμε την καρδιά μαύρη σαν καμινάδα. Ω, μάνα μου, μαύρη σαν καμινάδα. Thank you.
Now Dimitris is going to sing another song that was made very famous by Stelios Fustalieris from Rethymno, another old Ottoman-era urban song from Crete called Osu Varun Ta Sidera. Όσο βαρούν τα σίδερα, βαρούν τα μαύρα ρούχα. Γιατί και εγώ τα φόρεσα για μια αγάπη πουχα. Black clothes, I know that black clothes are as heavy as iron, can be as heavy as iron, because I also wore them because of a love that once I had. Okay, we're now going to play a dance. It's a very special, it's a dance that's very special in Western Crete called the pedozali or pedozalis. It's a great example of how important oral history is in this part of the world because the name pedozali means the dance with five steps. It's a dance that has 12 specific melodies that are played to it, and all of these numbers are very important because supposedly, according to tradition, it was invented in 1759, 69? Yeah, sometime in the middle of the 18th century as a way to bring together the 12 local leaders of a rebellion against the Ottoman Turks, and the name Pedozali, the fifth step, is supposedly the fifth organized attempt to gain freedom from the Ottomans. What we do know is that it's an extremely popular, extremely aggressive, as we would say, warlike dance that some people claim is genetically connected to the pirichios, or the ancient war dance of the Minoans. The jury is still out on this. But what's important, as any folklorist will tell you, is not the objective truth, but what people believe and what they do with it. So here's a pedozali. Re. Αρχινά από ρε, ε. So now we're going to play, we have two more little sets of selections for you. Right now we're going to play a song and three dance melodies that are explicitly associated with the former Muslim population of Crete, the so-called Cretan Turks, or Turkish Cretans, the Turco-Kritiki. I mean, in reality, the largest part of that population were Greek-speaking people who converted to Islam for various reasons over the course of the centuries. There was a very small population of urban Ottoman Turks, Turkish-speaking Muslims. But most of the Turkish Cretans, in most of the aspects of their daily lives, certainly the musical and poetic ones, were indistinguishable almost from their Christian counterparts. And among their number were a great many important musicians, dancers, singers, and composers. So we're going to sing, Venizelos is going to sing a beautiful old song called that we call the Stafidianoskopos, was composed by a man named Mehmet Stafidakis, who was a landowner in western Crete in the mid to late 19th century. And he was also a very accomplished performer on the boulgari, which is an instrument that is particularly associated with the urban Turkish Cretan population. So this is a song that he supposedly would begin all of his glendia, his big music parties that he played at with. And it's also the melody that he sang to his estranged wife on his deathbed when he died of a broken heart after catching her with one of his best friends. And then we're going to play... And then after that, very somber piece, we're going to go into three sirtos dances that were composed by one of the last great Turkish Cretan musicians to live on Crete, a man named Mustafas Karagules. Karagules, Karagül in Turkish means black rose. It was his, I don't know if it was his family name or his nickname, but he was from the village of you know that village she was from. Kalergiana. So he composed four sirta tunes. We're going to play three of them. The first two that bear his name, we just call them Karagules, and then one of my favorite ones, a very tricky one called Yusufis. So, Stafidianos Skopos.
Oh,
δικό μου, κάνει ό,τι δικό μου για σέμι. Καστελιανό μου φούλη, Καστελιανό μου φούλη. Ο Καραγιούλες, γιατί σε με, γιατί σε μέρα κυβικό.
Thank you very much. We are going to, in just a minute, have a celebratory toast in honor of Paddy. But before we do, we'll play one more selection, a final risitico, Potis Thakani Xasteria, a song about waiting for daylight to come to descend from the mountain and wreak havoc on the enemy. One of the heaviest and darkest risitico songs, but the music doesn't belie that at all. And then we'll play, of course, how could we not, since we're at a conference in honor of Paddy Fermor, whose nickname among the andartes was File Dem. How could we not play File Dem? So File Dem is a song From what I gather, he got this nickname because he incessantly sung it and drove everybody crazy. This is a song, it's another, we think, Turkish-Cretan song. Its origin is muddy and cloudy, but it's a really wonderful melody. If you sing it, if you know it, please sing along the refrain. If you don't know it, you'll learn it. It's very easy. I also have, I learned something yesterday. I told Dimitri and Venizelo something, a coincidence that's leaves the realm of serendipity and gets a little bit creepy, in a good way, metaphysical. I was speaking with a friend of mine who's a mutual friend of Dimitri's, has a couple of instruments, an American musician named Roger Landis. Great bouzouki player, but plays Irish-style bouzouki. Long story, we can talk about it later. But Roger used to run a music festival that I would often play at. I was telling Roger, I was talking to him yesterday, saying I'm coming here to Copenhagen. He said, oh, yeah, Paddy Fermor, a great hero of mine. He said, you remember when Paddy died, right? And I said, well, I don't remember, but I mean, I know it was 2011, I believe, right? June. And he said, well, you remember the moment, don't you? And I said, no, of course. How would I remember the moment? And he said, well, I suppose I never told you. He said, you were on stage at the festival playing bouzouki that Dimitris made for you, and you were singing Filedem, and my phone rang, and so I ran out of the room, and it was a friend of mine in Britain who was calling me to tell me that Paddy Fermor had just passed away. So, just amazing. I'm amazed that happened, and I'm amazed that I didn't know about it until yesterday, right as I was arriving at Copenhagen. So, anyway, so we'll sing Xasteria, and then we'll play Filedem. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you to the organizers of this wonderful symposium. Thanks to all of you for coming and for sticking around and sharing this music with us. So again, on the Cretan laouto, Venizelos Leventogiannis, which is the most, to me, sounds like the most Cretan name ever. I was telling him, but it's actually from his non-Cretan side. And Dimitris Rapakousios, which is also, despite being descended from people from Kusto Gerako, the last name is from Epiros. And Panagiotis Paddy League.
Ποτέ στα καμίξα στεριά, ποτέ στα φλεβαρίσι, ποτέ στα φλεβαρίσι να πάρω το, να πάρω το του φέτσι μου, να πάρω το, να πάρω το. Ωραί την όμορφη πατρόνα, την όμορφη πατρόνα να κατεβώ, να κατεβώ στον ομαλό. Να κάμω μα, να κάμω μανές δίχως γιους. Ωραί γυναίκες δίχως άντρες, γυναίκες δίχως άντρες, να κάνω και να κάνω και μωρά παιδιά. Να κάνω να κλαίνει
γραμμή στα στεριά.
Thank you very much. We'll now